children attacked by three pit bulls in three different parts of the city, and all that happened within just the past 7 days. So is anyone planning to take legal action to get tougher laws on either pit bulls or possibly their owners? WDSU News anchor Rachel Wolf went to find that out today. So, Rachel, you spoke with the SPCA. Are they pushing for tougher laws maybe on pit bulls and their owners?
Well, they actually talked about this last fall. It's called an intact ordinance. And what that is dogs that are not spayed or neutered, basically dogs that people are breeding, would need to be registered. And that way they can make sure the dogs have their rabies shots, they can make sure that they're healthy, and that also that they are contained if, in fact, one of those dogs actually gets out. So this is an ordinance they tried to get passed last year, and actually they're thinking about it this spring. The LA SPCA is supporting this ordinance, and also that ordinance, not yet any schedules to when Cynthia Hedge Morrell's office would actually propose that in city council, but we're hearing that it could happen this spring.
So again, we were talking about three different children involved in these pit bull attacks. What's the condition of the boy involved in the latest attack?
That little boy you just saw was 5-year-old Adrian Thompson. He lives in the Gentilly area, and he was at his great-grandma's house. He is doing better. He was just bitten in the leg. He apparently was at school today, according to his family, and he is recovering just fine. That's a younger picture of him. But again, he's doing much better today.
So what's going to happen to the pit bull, the dog that was involved in all of this?
Well, they had to take that dog. They had to tase it. I mean, this was a dog that was roaming and pretty much out of control, according to the neighbors there. They brought that dog into the LASPCA. It is over on the West Bank at their shelter at this point in time, and they said they're going to hold it for 10 days. They need to make sure the dog doesn't have any rabies, and then with the do is they will put the dog down.